I want to share with you why we found attractive these kind of industries. First of all, as Paolo says, there is an undergoing paradigm shift in this industry. So from temple to forum, introduced in the 1971, so it's a very old paradigm that starts to change in this year with Cameron, that was the director of the Brooklyn Museum. And the focus become even more on the customer. So it's not the museum that push content to the visitors, but museum then tries to interact. So to move from a temple to a forum with a lot of form of interaction between visitors during the entire customer journey. So for users that want to become informed about the collection before the visit, for users that want more information during the visit, and for users that want to discover more in depth something after the visit. The visiting process. Also, another reason is that the complexity introduced by digital technologies, the causal ambiguity, is very high in this industry. So, because it's not just a form of digitization, if I can come back to the Adriano's question, it's not just to digitize something to make a digital copy. The process is very complex, I will show you why, and there isn't a good receipt for the museum, for the cultural institution to address this digital transformation. And of course, it's a very traditional industry in which we have the entry of new vertical digital actors like Google. And there are also another couple of platforms, but I would say Google is the worldwide leading platform in this industry. There are four main trends that accelerate the path of digital transformation for the cultural industry. So first of all, the indoor navigation. So iBeacon, the multimedia guide, the app, the QR code inside the gallery. Then we have also new ways of seeing. I will show you a technology developed by Google that is called Gigapixel. That is the digitization of an image, but not just simple digitization. It is an image that counts, if I remember well, 10 billion pixels. So it's something that is very huge to maintain on the server, and so we need Google for this kind of activity, because we have to download in real time this kind of picture. And to download 10 billion pixels, I think that you will spend 3-4 hours. We have augmented reality, we have the street view, and also we have external pressure to change. So we have social media, a new form of interaction between museum and users. The last thing that is the main topic of the presentation is the internal pressure to change. So all the industries are changing. The museum industry is a very traditional industry, but now they understand that to keep the pace of the other sectors, they need to evolve. So they need to lead the digital transformation. And this is leading transformation process is based on several points. So coming back to Valerio, if we digitize something that is physical, we can do it in different way. We can create a digital counterpart of a physical object. So a convergence. We have a book and we have an ebook. So exactly the same content. On the other side, we can have the smartification process. So we have a physical artifact, the shoes, what Paolo said with Adidas, implemented by some sensors. So something different, something more than digital that enable new functionalities. And then we have the virtualization process. In this case, we have a bidirectional flow between physical and digital. So there is a form of interaction in terms of immersive experience, simulation, experimentation, and so on and so forth. So there are three different kinds of digitization. It's not just the creation of a digital counterpart of a physical object. The second point is the value creation and the stakeholder alignment. And I'll add this point because it could be important for your project work for the deliverable tree. So most of you are working on the traditional value chain logic, but in the digital world, the value chain become a value network. So we have different stakeholders with different interests and different perspectives. So I'll show you the case of the museum. We have the users that want to access to content or to cultural content. We have the researchers that want to study the artworks in a different way, so they want to reduce their search cost. We have other museums and competitors that want globally to extend their collection, to extend their visibility to a wider community. We have the suppliers, the guys that develop the technology and try to go to the museum. Do you want to buy this? Do you want to buy that? We have the tourism institution that, of course, want to promote the local environment. So want to be present on Google to promote the region, the country, the city. And we have also the policymaker that, of course, want to preserve, that is the previous question, and want to promote the country. So the takeaway is that the higher the capability to enact multiple value drivers, so in this case, assets, reducers, scores, extend the collection, promote the collection, the higher the convergence in this interest, the higher is the value created among the ecosystem. So in the digital world, we are talking about ecosystem, non-traditional value chain. And an example is a designer for IKEA. So this is an online community that built a computer desk from a crib. So something new, or what we have seen before, TaskRabbits, so for the delivery process. Again, the strategy before technology. And there is this smart guy that say, you have got to start with the customer experience and work backwards to the technology. That we have these, the fact that we discussed it with some of the groups yesterday, with group 20, you don't have to define the technology. We need the virtual experience for IKEA. What is the customer experience? What is the customer journey? What are the primary needs for customers? Then we come back to the technology. If you start with the technology, you cannot answer to the user requirement, to the primary need of user in your case. The last thing is the organizational change. That is the main topic of the presentation. I'll show you how digital technology is changing internally the organization, how the organization co-evolve to address the digital transformation. We conducted a case study on the Van Gogh Museum. Why the Van Gogh is the best-in-class museum, is the most admired gallery in Europe, is the second one worldwide, just following the Louvre in Paris. It's a public cultural institution, so it's not a private foundation and can invest a lot of money in developing digitization, virtual reality, augmented reality. It's a, let me say, a pretty constrained budget. And also because he has the most unique and the most largest the largest collection of the Van Gogh artworks in the world. So 205 paintings, 500 drawings, and more than 800 letters that are not available in the gallery. So some material that is not available in the gallery. How the Van Gogh Museum is using this kind of technology? So come to preservation to the first question. And quoting the head of digital department of the Van Gogh Museum, the digitization of the collection has allowed us to transform the physical and unique assets in something more, maintaining the uniqueness, but giving them a different digital identity. So not just physical equal to digital, the convergent, but something more, okay? For research purpose, so see the unseen. Here we have the cottage from Vincent van Gogh, 1985. This is one of the most admired paint in the Van Gogh Museum. Yeah, sorry, sorry. But we can see the paint in the gallery. But we cannot see what is, for instance, behind the painting. In this case, behind the painting, there is another painting, because the canvas was very expensive. And you can explore this kind of stuff just with digital technology. This is a mixture between X-rays and computer tomography. And beyond this canvas, there is a shepherd with sheep, so a totally different artworks. So this is just to say that with digital technology, we have new meaning in knowledge creation. That is the first point of the presentation. So new meaning in knowledge creation. In exhibition, we can see something that goes behind the naked eyes. I'll show you the bedroom. This is the bedroom. I think that all of you knows the bedroom in the on the wall of the physical gallery. This is the technology developed by Google that was used also by the Van Gogh Museum. We have the digitalization of the bedroom. So in this case, simple convergence, digital images of a physical object. But with the technology, we can zoom through the picture. And we can reach extremely high level of detail. So we can see the brushstroke. We can study the artwork from our home. If you are art lovers, you can do it. But if you are a researcher, it's an amazing opportunity to, you cannot study at this level of detail the artworks in the gallery. So it's a totally new concept of disseminate knowledge. The real thing, of course, is better in the gallery. You have the aesthetic experience with the artwork. But again, we have the second point of the presentation. Here you have new meaning in the knowledge dissemination. Okay, you can disseminate this kind of artworks by the internet, with Google or with the Van Gogh website. Content. This is the strategic variable. As Valeria said, there are a lot of content. What digital art is a multi-layer of content. I will show you why. In the gallery, you have the classic exhibition on the wall. Okay, so some few lines that curator give you to understand the painting. Then you have the website. And on the website, you have the same exhibit of the canvas, but you have something more. You have the cross-continent connection, the same that you find on Amazon when you choose a product. You have the video, the researching process, so in this case, the discoloration of the bedroom, the restoration process. And you have also the hyperlink. So in this case, the connection with the letters that Van Gogh wrote to his brother that are not available in the gallery. On the website, you find the images of the original letter, you find the original text, you find the translation, and you find the curator notes. So you have a full access to the bedroom, but also to the related content that are not available in the physical gallery. The bundling you can create with the internet, with Google, and not the bundling of different museums. On Google, you can see the bedroom. We have three versions of the bedroom: one in Amsterdam, one in Chicago, and one in Paris, in the Museum d'Orsay. On the same platform, you can compare and contrast the difference between the three bedrooms. That is something that you cannot do. Oh, if you have the opportunity to go in both the place, you are lucky. But I mean, it's something that not all of us can do. Or you can explore different museums by virtual gallery. So in this case, Facebook, so a social media that provide a live broadcast with the five virtual museums across three continents. So we have London, Amsterdam, and Munich for Europe, Philadelphia, and Tokyo, with a virtual exhibition that you can explore virtually with your smartphone. The education on site. Here we have a technology that is called Relievo, developed by Van Gogh Museum, that essentially works as a 3D printing through which impaired people can touch the artworks. And the level of detail is amazing. And of course, you cannot touch the original work, but you can touch a very good replica of the artworks. And this is based on 3D printing. The education online. So we talked about the education on site, but online you have now interaction with Instagram. You have the hashtag #curator. You can ask your question to curators that reply you with the Instagram story. So a totally different approach. And you have also the digital storytelling process, that what we mentioned during the customer journey. So you can choose, which painting would you like to learn more about? It's up to you. You can choose between two different paintings, you select one, and then the digital storytelling process starts. And in the end, how much do you like this painting? So it's a totally different approach. You are not pushing, the curator are not pushing content, but start form of interaction with the users. The e-commerce, we have the e-commerce. Of course, we have the traditional e-commerce object that we find in the shops, so the so-called souvenir. But again, we have new form of collaboration enabled by digital technologies. And for the Van Gogh Museum, so a very traditional institution specialized in Van Gogh, could be very strange to have a collaboration with Vans. Guys, they make a boom. They finished the collection in less than 1 week. Sold out everything, shoes, shirts, backpack. They made this collaboration with Vans and was an incredible success. How did they do? With the social media. So the new form of interaction became Instagram, in this case, from the Van Gogh Museum. A new form of commercialization of arts. Again, this is the same technology Relievo for impaired people, now used to sell certified copies of artworks. And I mean, it's a niche of market, so a very strict that customer segmentation, $22,000 for a replica. Okay, it's a replica, but it's certified by curator. So a totally new approach. We have open data, because conversely from Google, you can download from the Van Gogh Museum, the image, also in high resolution, and you can share the image on the social network. But this is not all the story, because you can share it on the social network, it's okay, it's nice, but you can co-create and you can reuse the image to create something new with user. This guy is a freelancer that created a digital reproduction of the bedroom and shares the reproduction on the social network. But this is a digital entertainment companies from China that creates something totally new. You start from the starry night, you walk into the bedroom, you come back in the starry night. So something that is totally new for this kind of industry. The movie, and it's not just the movie, is that the movie is created through Kickstarter. That is the most famous digital crowdfunding website. And last but not least, the Airbnb. They create a room exactly the same to the bedroom painted by Van Gogh in Chicago, and was present in the Airbnb platform in Chicago. So a totally new way to commercialize the idea of Van Gogh around the world. This is the third point. We have new meaning in knowledge commercialization. So Van's movie and the very expensive replica of the artworks. These are the three axes, let's say. Now we will see why. The point now is, we studied all this digital transformation, all this coevolution, but how the organizational really, all the museum really co-evolved to support the digital technology. So in 1995, I don't want to bother you with all the coevolution. I'll show you just three main points. At the beginning, we have silos. So the guys that produce content and knowledge, and the guys that make the exhibition in the physical gallery. Okay, these guys talk, but are not. It's just pushing content in the gallery, in the physical gallery. Then, with social network, social media, and with 3G, with the UMTS, with the first form of fast connectivity, they start to understand we have to change our approach. We have museum affairs that we call people that love objects, so curator, and public affairs that we call people that love people. But again, these are the guys, the curator that produce content, and these are the guys, marketing, that make just the promotion, that make Twitter. And so this form of communication didn't work well, because they say, we are the owner of the knowledge. You are just the guy that tweet some stuff on the internet. What they resolve the problem? They create a new digital department, a new liaison role between the people that love objects, the curator, and the people that love people, and of course they add the people that love money, the commercialization part, and this is the system integrator between the three, let's say, axes of the organization, okay? And this guy enables a bidirectional flow between all the process, the content creation process, and content dissemination process in the Van Gogh Museum. Guys, it's the same things that you have seen during the day two. We have the review provided by users, we have the data science, the extractor, we have the translator that have to communicate some information to the top management team. If the flow is from the other end, on the other side, so we have curator that provide content, we have the education that have to interpret the content, the digital communication department that translate content for user. So it's exactly the same. And this become the 2K role. So the translator in this case, for the top management team, your role during the project work, and the translator, the digital communication department, for the case of the Van Gogh Museum. And again, it's what Terry Buer says. We have three axes, technology, process, and practice. So we have the technology, the digital technologies. We have a well-defined process. I mean, the process of museum is the same. You have to disseminate your content in the best way. But to do this, Harry say adaptation, I would say more co-evolution of the organizational practice. You have to evolve your organizational structure to address the technological challenge, to lead the digital transformation. So these are the three axes. We have the museum affairs, the knowledge creation, the second one is the knowledge communication, and the third one is the knowledge commercialization. And this is the evolution. We move from a functional, hierarchical, siloed organization in 1995 to a very lean model, a collaborative model, with the digital communication department that act as a system integrator between the three axes. So I want just to conclude with a sum up of the presentation. Digitalization and connectivity enable new form of collaboration because we have a new we have to address needs not just from people that go to Amsterdam to see the collection, but from all over the world. So we have an outreach, increase the interest in the collection. And in this case, digital technology enables new form of collaboration between the organizational function. We have a new liaison role, in this case a new department, that becomes the system integrator between these three functions. And also, the Van Gogh Museum starts new way to commercialize content in new ways in order to make money, to monetize from artworks. So the fact that you make a digital replica and you sell it for 20,000 euro is a big change in your business model. More or less, these are the main aspects of our study. If you have questions, thank you.